back to my channel Buzzcraft. So today I'm going to be showing you all how to make a really cool paper boomerang. Okay, the materials you will be requiring is just an A4 sheet. Alright, so today I'm going to be showing you all how to make a mini boomerang. This model is designed by Rob's World. I'm going to leave a link to his channel in the description below. Okay, let's go ahead and start with the video. So you'll be requiring just one A4 sheet. Alright, okay, so to start, you want to hold your paper in landscape and you want to fold it in half. Alright, then you want to give it a good crease. Okay, so with one A4 sheet you can make 4 boomerangs. Alright, so let's go ahead and start. So you want to fold it into half, give it a good crease. Okay, now what you want to do is you want to fold this edge onto the middle edge. Alright, and then you want to give it a good squeeze. Okay, so I'm going to be showing you one boomerang. So it's advisably better that you want to make at least 4 boomerangs out of one sheet, so you know which flies better. Alright, okay, so now you want to unfold, and what you want to do is you want to cut onto this line right here. Okay, so if you want you can repeat it on this side also, so you get 4 units and you can cut each one further. Okay, so what I'm going to be doing is I'm just going to be go ahead and just going to tear this into, alright. If you want, you can use a scissor. Alright, I'm just gonna snip it off. Alright, so you wanna set that aside. Okay, now let's go ahead and work on with this. Okay. Alright, so now what you wanna do is you wanna fold this into half. Okay, so that this edge aligns onto this edge. This model is a bit long and there are a few tricky parts, but once you do it and you have a hang of it, it's really easy to make. Alright, okay, then you want to give it a good squeeze. Okay, this model really requires precision. Alright, okay, now what you want to do is you want to fold this edge onto the middle edge, but what you want to do is you want to leave about half a millimeter. Alright, so it's easy in folding because you don't want the center to be heavy or it's just gonna go and fold about half a millimeter or a millimeter. Alright, okay, you want to repeat that on both the sides. Okay, so what I am going to do is I'm going to take this and I'm going to fold onto that and then go once again fold onto that, so I just have my guideline right here. So you want to unfold and you just maybe want to just fold onto that approx. Alright, maybe you just want to push the paper towards the up. Alright, okay, alright, okay, so once you have done this, what you want to do is now you want to fold it into half, but you need really clean fold. So what you got to do is you need your 4 fingers and you just want to push into the middle, estimating the center. Alright, then you want to align both the edges and you just want to crease right there. You may just want to pull onto that, okay, because you need a really clean fold right there. Okay, alright, you just want to give a good crease. Alright, now what you want to do is you want to make an airplane fold right here. So what you want to do is you want to align this edge onto this middle edge. Alright, it's like an airplane fold. So you maybe just want to hold on to here because it's just going to slide and your folds are not going to be precise. Okay, give it a good squeeze. Alright, okay, you want to unfold and you want to flip over your model, and what you want to do is you want to hold once again and you want to fold back onto that. Alright, and then give it a good squeeze. Unfold. Okay, now what you want to do is, sorry, okay, you want to open up and you're going to have a pocket right here. So you just want to push onto that right there and then you want to close. Okay, so there we have one pocket. Now let's repeat the process on the other. Okay, so you just want to hold onto the paper and you want to, this video is a bit long, right, compared to my other videos. Okay, then you want to turn over and you want to repeat once again. Okay, alright, unfold and open up your pocket and you just want to tuck that in. Okay, okay, now just crease sharply on this. Okay, Just press down everything. Give good grease. Okay. You're on. Flip and then. Alright. Okay. Now what you want to do is, you want to unfold only till there. Okay. Now what you want to do is, now comes a tricky bit. Okay. If you're right-handed, you want to open the right flap. And if you're a left-handed, you want to open the left flap. Alright. So I'm a right-handed, so I'm going to be opening the right flap. Okay. Now what you want to do is, once you open that, you just want to push onto that crease from the bottom, like so. Right? And then you want to crease that. It's a valley fold, so you want to convert it into a mountain fold. So you want to crease that. Okay. Now what you want to do is, you want to push onto the other crease from bottom. And you just want to pop it out and you just want to go ahead and crease. You want to repeat it on the other. You just want to make this a little stable so it gives good flight. Alright. Okay. Okay. Alright. Once you have done that, you want to flip over your model so it remains on your right hand side. Okay. Now what you want to do is, from this point right here to this point right here, okay, you want to fold up to there. Alright. You want to fold up to there. Okay. Now what is going to happen is, there's a small triangle at the back, right? This one, okay? Not this, not this, not this. This one right here, okay? You want to push onto that so that the middle edge right there aligns with the crease on the paper, alright? Okay? Then you just want to crease sharply, alright? Okay, now what you want to do is, you want to, from the bottom, okay? It is like this, and then you want to turn. And from the bottom, you want to push onto the rest two triangles and you want to flatten it out like so. Okay. So now once you have done that, what you want to do is, you can see a crease right here, this one right here and this one right here. Okay. So you want to fold onto that and you want to fold onto that crease right here. Okay. Now what's going to happen is, you're going to have a tab which is going to pop out and you want to fold it towards your left hand side. Okay, this does not matter if you're a right-handed or a left-handed. Okay, you just want to fold it to your left hand side. Alright. Okay. So once you have done that, now comes the tricky bit. You just want to adjust that a bit. That's not a tricky bit, don't worry. Okay, once you've done adjusting, what you want to do is, you want to pick both the flaps up. Okay, and you want to pick this bottom flap and just fold it towards the in. Okay. And then you just want to flatten it back again. And you want to crease sharply. Alright. So now what we're going to do is, we are going to tuck this right here in inside. Okay. Okay. So what you want to do is, you want to pick this flap right here. And you want to pick this flap right here. Okay. Up to this crease only. Okay. You just want to pick right there. And then you want to fold right there. And what you want to do is, you want to just round this corner a bit so you can tuck it inside. Alright, you just want to tuck it completely towards the inside, okay, and then you want to flatten it out, okay. And what you want to do is, you just want to push onto the paper. You may want to just lick your finger, so you can just push onto the paper, not too hard, okay, it's going to spoil the shape, okay. So that's pretty much it, that's our boomerang right there. Now what we have to do is, we just got to lock the corners, right, okay. So you have something like this, alright. So now what you want to do is, to the right hand side, you want to pick this one right here and you want to unfold. Okay, what you right have here is a pocket, okay, and not another pocket. So you have only one pocket right here. So what you want to do is, you want to make an airplane fold right here, like so. So you want them to align on the middle edge, right? Both ways. Fine. Give it a good squeeze. Okay, now what you want to do is, you want to unfold and rotate. And the side with the pocket, right, you just want to open that, and the triangle right here, you just want to push onto that from the back, okay, and then you may just want to pop this out. Okay, this model is a little between intermediate and difficult, okay. So you just gonna have a tab like that, okay, and then you just want to push that up, okay. So now what you want to do is, you want to fold. But you don't want to fold this towards in, you want to keep that open. But you just want to keep the crease right there. Okay, so what you want to do is, you want to flip over your model. And as you can see, if you open that right there, okay? You have a small pocket right here, okay? So now what you want to do is you want to round this tab right here and you want to insert it in. So what you got to do is you want to just round it off, alright? And you just want to tuck it in. You may want to adjust it from the back, alright? You may want to just push it in with the help of your fingers. Okay, that's one. Now let's go ahead and repeat it on the other side. So now what we have done is we have completed our right hand side. Now we're going to go ahead and do the left hand side. But as you can see, the left hand side, it does not have a pocket towards the in, it has this towards the out. Okay, so now what we're going to do is we're going to flip over a model like this, and as you can see right here, there is only two flaps. There is no such flap on this side. Okay, so now comes the tricky bit. What you want to do is you again want to just repeat onto your airplane fold. Alright, you want to be delicate with the paper because it's really fragile. Okay, and you don't want the paper to tear at all. Okay, alright. So once you have done that, you want to unfold both the flaps. Alright, now what you want to do is you want to unfold this entire flap, and the crease closest to this point right here, which is this one, you just want to push onto that from the back and lay it down onto the surface of the paper, and then you just want to close onto that, so you have something like that. Okay, now what you want to do is, since you have this fold right here, you want to unfold that. Okay, fold it back, flatten it out, and you're gonna have once again a pocket right here. So you want to round that bit right there, and you want to open up the pocket, alright, and you want to tuck that in. Okay, you may want to adjust. Okay, once you have done that, you just want to crease everything sharply. Alright, and I'm going to be teaching you how to fly this model also. Crease everything sharply, press onto the center. Alright, okay, so now this was the surface on which we worked. So this is not the surface, so there's no pocket right here, as you can see. So if you flip over your model, you'll have a pocket right here. So this is going to be your face and this is going to be your back. Alright, to identify, what you're going to do is you just want to bend it into half and you can see a pocket. So now you can recognize that this is your face. The face with the pocket, right, at the left hand side or the right hand side is your face. Alright, so to fly this, this is a boomerang. This is a mini boomerang. So I'm going to be teaching you all how to make the normal regular boomerang also. It is also really simple. Okay, so what you have to do is you want to hold an A4 sheet in portrait and you want to fold it into half. And then you want to cut it, and then you're going to have two units. So you want to use one unit and repeat the entire same process to have a really cool boomerang, alright? So that's how you make the regular boomerang. This is how you make the mini boomerang. So I thought this is going to be easier because a bigger boomerang, the original one, is a little bigger and it's tougher to fly, okay? Okay, now I'm going to be showing you how to fly this. So you want to hold face up, and what you want to do is, with your middle finger right here and your ring finger, you want to place it below this and you want to grab your thumb on top and your middle and your index finger at the bottom and your thumb at the top. Okay, so and then what you want to do is you want to keep your thumb right over here. Okay, now what you want to do is when you are throwing it, what you want to do is you just want to flick your wrist, alright, like this. So what you want to do is you don't want to throw it horizontally. You may want to throw it at an angle of about 25 degrees, alright? So you want to just throw it like that. So I'm not going to be showing you how to really throw this, but when I'm going to be making the original boomerang in a tutorial later in future, I'm going to be showing you how to throw it. So I'm just going to be teaching you. See, your index and your middle finger at the bottom and your thumb at the top and your index right here on the edge. Okay, now what you want to do is you may, if your boomerang is not flying really well, okay, you want to just hold on to that and just bend that a bit and then place it on the table and just flatten it out, because you don't want to really bend it a lot. Okay, so you want to hold it in the same position and you just want to throw it like this while just flicking your wrist, alright? So tell me in the comments that does it work or not. If it does not, I may make some aerodynamic changes to this. Alright, so So there we have it, guys. That's a really cool boomerang. Hope you enjoyed this video. Don't forget to like, share and subscribe to my channel. Don't forget to hit the bell icon so you're notified about my latest videos. Stay safe. Bye.